Hey YouTube, welcome to my channel. So in this video today, I am going to be showing you guys another braidless crochet braids, and this is gonna be a step-to-step tutorial. So I just went ahead and did the back of my hair because I didn't want this video to be too long. So I went ahead and did the back. So I'm going to show you guys how I do the front. The way I do the front is the way you do the back. So I'm just going to show you guys step to step because a lot of people been asking me how to do this style and they're still confused or whatever. So I wanted to come here and make a detailed video of how I do this hairstyle. And I keep cutting my natural hair, so like my hair may seem like it's forever not growing. It's because I keep cutting it every 4 months. So I'm just the type of female that cut hair, I guess. But this is for anybody that has long short hair. If you don't want to put too much tension on your scalp by braiding your hair in cornrows, this is another option that you can do. If you're tender-headed like myself, I'm very tender-headed, and sometimes that's why I don't keep hairing my hair that long, because my hair would stop hurting and stuff like that. It would start hurting, so I had to take it out. So I decided to start doing the rubber band method. The rubber band method is a little bearing, so yeah, ever since I started doing it, I like it. It's easy, it's fast, and yep, it doesn't take no time at all. So let's get into the video. So this is 1.5 packs in my hair, y'all. And this is a Featress braid crochet hair. So this is a kiss style type of hair. So, you know, like I didn't want to spend so much money because the hair prices are just going up for some reason at the local beauty supply store. So I decided to just do kids, okay, hair. So I have a kids hairstyle in my head. Doesn't matter as long as it look good. That's all I care about. So this is the Featress braid, and this is what it looks like. And this is a 8-inch crochet braid, and you get 3 times the bundle in 1 pack. This is, like I said, this is 8-inch, and this is the inner color number 1, and this is for kids. You can see the baby on here, but I didn't really care, you know, like, I don't care. I can still rock it, and I'm going to go ahead and just show you guys. Like I said, this is 1.5 packs, y'all. Like, I'm still on my, this is my 2nd pack. I'm still on it. So, literally, I have 1.5 packs in my head. I wanted it to be full, but I wanted it not too full. I wanted it to be full. That makes sense. So I'm going to show you guys how I do this. I have my mirror here so that way I can pay attention to what I'm doing. So basically, I'm doing the net. If you got short hair like me, if you cut your hair as much as I do, if you have short hair like me, okay, and you want to do the rubber band method, you have to use a net. Regardless of net or not, I always use a net when I'm doing my hair. It's because, I don't know, I feel like the net helps the hair to last longer. It helps the hair to stay fresh, and it also helps the hair to grow. So, yeah, so let's get into the video. So I went ahead and put a net on my head. So I'm going to show you guys how I do the remaining portion of my hair. So y'all, okay, let me see if I can come closer to this camera. Some of y'all been really confused lately about this tutorial, so I want to show you guys in details. So what I do is I just grab like, I don't know how to really explain it, y'all. I go through my natural hair and the net together, and I just pull the needle through because I don't want my hair to be too full, and this curl pattern is very thick, so I usually just split it in two. You can split this hair many times, like into 4 strands, but I'm only gonna do 2 strands, okay? So when I split it, I just like to run my hand through there to make sure there's no frays or nothing. And I like to put it So I put the hair through the hook, I close it, and then I just pull, and I go through the loop about twice, and I pull, and then I like to tie it. Okay, so that's about, that's like it. It's very simple. So basically, I grab my natural hair, I put it through the net, and put it through the net, and then I just pull the hair through the hook, close it, pull, and just go through the loop twice, pull, and then I like to tie it. And if you know how to do crochet braid, you've been watching crochet for a long time, it's just the same step. It's just the difference is it's the rubber band. It's just like the same step, y'all. So this to me is just a lot easier than doing all that braiding, and I'm tender headed, so I just can't. So I'm just gonna put the hair through the lash, okay, and I'm gonna close that, and I'm gonna pull. I don't know how to explain stuff. So I think it's better that you guys just watch me and then learn. Let me see if I can come closer. So, pull it through. Okay, so that's basically like what I do, y'all. Like, I'm so sorry, I am not a good teacher. Some people just learn by watching, and some people learn by, I don't know, others talking, but I just prefer just showing you guys instead of just talking. So I'm just gonna go through the braid and then put the hair through there. Okay, so I do want a side part, so the side part is gonna be maybe right here. So I will be getting off camera to do my side part, because I want my side part to look very, very nice and neat. So I just wanted to show you guys the basic of how I do the braidless hairstyle. So you want to pull the needle through the hair, okay? Put the fake hair in a hook, close the hook, pull the hook until you have a loop right here. You want to go through the loop twice, okay? After you go through the loop twice, pull down, and then you want to tie the hair. Just like that. It's so simple, y'all. Like, maybe some people on YouTube might explain this more better than I do, but I'm doing my best. Okay, y'all, so I am done with my hair. I have to get off camera to finish my part because I wanted my part to look very, very pretty, and it turned out really, really good. So let me go ahead and show you guys my part. So this is what my part looks like how I wanted it. So it comes like all the way here and it gets like a little swoop or whatever. So this is my edges. I'm not gonna go ahead and cut the net because it's not necessary, because my hair is short in front, so I'm just gonna leave the net there. But this is the finished look of this tutorial. So I want to go ahead and just turn around so you guys can see what the back is looking like. So when I turn around, this is what the back is looking like. The back is very full. It's very full. It's the way I like it. And this is the side of the hair. And this is the other side. So the back is pretty full. And I really wanted it like that. I wanted it full everywhere. Not too full, but full enough that I can bear the weight. But this is what the hair is looking like. And this is the Featress Braid for Kids Deep Twist. And this is 8-inch crochet hair in my head. And the color that I have is the color number 1. And I have literally, I have 2.5 packs left over. I got 5 packs of hair and I use 2.5 packs, and I got 2.5 packs left over. So you don't need too much of that hair because I did a lot of splitting. If you see, my hair is split into 2. So one of the strands is so thick, so what I did was I split it into 2. And sometimes you can get 3 strands out of 1 hair or 4 strands out of 1 hair. But I just decided to just do 2 strands. And I got this look. I did not shape this hair. I did not cut this hair. I didn't do anything. I haven't put no product in this hair at all yet. And I'm not going to put any product in this hair for a while, maybe like for a week. I'm gonna try to keep it in for maybe 2 weeks. 2 weeks at the most. It depends on how the curls is looking throughout the week. And also, I will be making another video on removing this hair out of your head. So a lot of people have been wondering how to remove the hair, so I will be making a second video showing you guys how to remove this hair, so that way for those of you who are wondering, we'll have a part 2 of this video. So yeah, that's it for this tutorial. This hair costs about $6, so I got 5 packs. I think what I have in my hair right now is like maybe $13 at the most. $13 give me this whole hairstyle. So that's it for this video. I hope I was helpful. So don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and click on the notification bell to keep up with me. And I'll be talking to you guys later. Bye-bye.